Good evening. All right, so welcome to the end of summer concert of the Mahoosuc Community Band. That first piece, I guess it's officially called the Colonel Bogey March. I like to think of it as the Colonial Boogie. It's composed in 1914 by Lieutenant F.J. Ricketts. He was the pen name for Kenneth J. Alford, a British composer, lived from 1881 to 1945. That melody, you probably all recognize, has had considerable mileage, both literally and figuratively. It started as a British military march, was adopted by the Canadian Expeditionary Force, and continued on with the American Women's Army Corps. It has appeared in movies, TV, and advertising, including Bridge Over the River Kwai, The Parent Trap, Spaceballs, The Man in the High Tower, and in 1967 even made it into the Bollywood film The Jewel Thief. The title of this song is rumored to be why golfers refer to a hole played one stroke over par as a bogey. I'd especially like to thank Jonathan Smith for all his work rescoring this piece for the euphonium section. Otherwise, it would have been much worse. All right, next up, A Walk in the Morning Sun, a much more modern piece from 2010 by the composer Pierre Lafont, who is a living composer, born in 1943, from Wisconsin, taught high school, middle school, and lower school music for 35 years, which means he earns a sainthood somewhere. Simon, our conductor, once referred to LaPlante as the Midwestern Leroy Anderson. We have no other Anderson songs in the concert, but I am guessing Leroy Anderson will reappear in our winter concert. This is a bio song by Steve White in memory of Peggy White. So, A Walk in the Morning Sun.
Thank you.
The next piece is called Earth, Wind, and Fire in Concert. Earth, Wind, and Fire are one of the best-selling musical groups of all time, selling over 90 million albums. The band was started in 1969 by Maurice White. It's one of the most influential acts in modern music, as evidenced by the number of performers who have covered their tunes and cited them as major inspirations, from Taylor Swift to Prince to the Beatles to Miles Davis. This medley includes four songs. September, written in 1978, was a number 8 Billboard Top 100. On this song, songwriter Ali was quoted as saying about writing the song with Maurice White, "I learned my greatest lesson ever in songwriting from him, which was never let the lyric get in the way of the groove." Second song is After the Love Is Gone, also from 1978, a number 2 Billboard Top 100, and won a Grammy Award. Fantasy from 1977, number 12 on the Billboard. And this song features a saxophone solo by Regina and the trumpet section channeling the Phoenix horn section. This is a Byatt song from Tom DeLuca. So, Earth, Wind, and Fire in Concert.
Thank you.
So, after hearing that song, you may have said to yourself, well, what exactly is a bias song? Ah, well, I'll tell you. If there's a song that you'd like to hear this band play, we can make that happen. You can talk to someone on the music committee, like Ryan or Ed or Mr. President back there, Scott or Julie. Seems like there's a lot of trumpets. Maybe Tom.
Yeah,
there's a lot of trumpets on it. Which, hearing that piece, doesn't surprise me very much. Anyway, so, if you want a song, think of something exciting, talk to one of those people, and we'll make it happen for you. We'll try to make it happen for you. We have no one. All right, anyway, next up is a song called All Aboard. This train is bound for glory. It was written by Nathan Farrell. He's a living composer, still with us, born in 1969. He's the fine arts director at Northside Christian School in St. Petersburg, Florida. Another one of those people who's been teaching music, conducting music, marching bands, concert bands, and producing musicals. This features the trombones and a Tobias song by Ellen Whitney in memory of her father, Cleve Lovejoy. So, all aboard. Lost its dominance bebop and other genres in the 1940s, Goodman relearned how to play his clarinet and began playing and recording classical music. He continued to perform, giving his last concert 6 days before he died of a heart attack. This compilation includes Let's Dance from 1935, written by Gregory Stone and Joseph Bonin. Stompin' at the Savoy from 1936, written by Benny Goodman, Edgar Sampson, and Chick Webb. Moonglow from 1934, by Will Hudson, Eddie Lang, and Irving Mills. And finally, Sing, Sing, Sing from 1936 by Louis Prima. This piece features the clarinets and some solos by Al. As the first song suggests, you're free to dance. This is, definitely. If you don't like dancing, please move out to the aisles, out in front of them. Join Simon in his dancing. All right. So here we go. Benny Goodman, the King of Swing. Yeah. Pioneering of hard rock and heavy metal, and for their album focus, releasing very few songs as singles, and for their huge stadium shows. They were also one of the bands with a reputation for vast excess during their concert tours, including the occasionally damaged hotel room. This includes four songs, one called Rock and Roll, one called Black Dog, one called Kashmir, and the last, Stairway to Heaven. Members of the band, three out of the four, are still with us. Jimmy Page was born in 1944. He's the primary music writer, so what we're playing is really Jimmy Page and their guitarist. Robert Plant is the vocalist and lyricist. He was born in 1948. John Paul Jones, bassist and keyboards from 1946. And John Bonham lived from 1948 to 1980. He was the drummer, and when he died, the band disbanded. That was it. This includes a trumpet solo by Julie, and it's a bio song from the Bethel Opera House. So, opera presenting heavy metal. Next. All right, here we go. Led Zeppelin on tour.
Thank you.
Next up is a song called In the Shining of the Stars. It's written in 1995 by a composer named Robert Sheldon, another living composer, another music educator, taught instrumental music in the Florida and Illinois public schools, and has served on the faculty at Florida State University. He is actively conducting and composing all around the world. So, next up, In the Shining of the Stars by Robert Sheldon. Next up, another medley, The Home Front, musical memories from World War II. Probably include some songs you've heard. First song is It's Been a Long, Long Time by Jewel Stein. Stein also wrote the musical Gypsy and the musical Funny Girl, which is currently back on Broadway. The next song is Thanks for the Memory by Leo Robin and Ralph Ranger. Robin and Stein, that's the previous composer, wrote Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend. Bell Bottom Trousers by Mo Jaffe. For several summers, Jaffe brought his band to the Poland Spring House in Poland Spring, Maine, where they were the house orchestra.
Has anyone ever seen them there? No, it was a long time ago. All right. The next song is The White Cliffs of Dover by Walter Kent. Kent also wrote I'll Be Home for Christmas. Next is I'll Be Seeing You by Sammy Thain. And then Don't Sit Under the Apple Tree by Charlie Tobias, who also wrote the Merry Melodies theme song. You know, bah, 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 bah. Someone wrote that. It's this guy. Yeah.
Where you get that?
What? No, it's true. According to Wikipedia. And finally, the last song in the medley is Praise the Lord and Pass the Ammunition by Fred Lesser, who lived from 1937 to 1945. That can't be right. That's too little. No. All right. He lived longer than that, I'm sure. Because he also wrote Guys and Dolls and the lyrics for Heart and Soul. You know, that song? Someone wrote that. This guy. This is a bio song from Kay and Jim Rector. So, the home front, musical memories from World War II.
Thank you. Thank you.
our encore, but it's really just our last song because we don't have another one. So that's the way it goes. just so there's no confusion at the end. This is the last song. So, this song, Loads of Fun, Jump, Jive, and Whale, from 1956, by Louis Prima. So we're back to Louis Prima again. Remember, he wrote Sing, Sing, Sing? Sing, Sing, Sing. Yeah, Sing, Sing, Sing earlier in the Benny Goodman piece. And Louis Prima is always fun. He lived from 1910 to 1978. Well, it's not fun anymore, but I mean, the song music's fun. He's a jazz composer and performer, but most importantly, he was the voice actor for King Louis in Disney's The Jungle Book in 1969. If you hear the song, you'd be like, oh yeah, that's Louis Prima. 1969, yeah. I know, we're old. The Jungle Book? That's old. All right, here we go. Jump, Jive, and Whale, and Whale by Louis Prima.
Next up is a song called In the Shining of the Stars. It's written in 1995 by a composer named Robert Sheldon, another living composer, another music educator.